gather round people, I'll tell you a story, an 8-year-long story of power and pride. British Lord Vesty and Vincent Lingiari were opposite men on opposite sides.
Vincent Lingiari played an important role in the struggle to achieve Indigenous rights, particularly in the area of land rights and working conditions.
Broad was his door.
Vincent Lingiari was born on Wave Hill Cattle Station in 1919. He was the son of two Gurindji workers. Wave Hill Cattle Station was established in the 1880s. When British settlers drove cattle onto Gurindji land, they put fences around water holes, trampled food plants, and shot wildlife. They forced the Gurindji to work on Wave Hill Cattle Station if they wanted to stay in their country.
But once they had gathered the wealth of the land, daily depression got tighter and tighter.
They were paid in rations of flour, sugar, tea, tobacco, beef scraps, and $6 a week if they were lucky.
They picked up their swags and started off walking at what a creek.
Vincent Lingiari decided to stand up against the inequality of the situation. He appealed to the owner, a British beef company called Vesty, Group for Better Pay and Working Conditions. In fact, until 1968, it was illegal to pay Aboriginal workers more than a certain amount in goods and wages. When Vincent Lingiari was unsuccessful, he organised the Wave Hill Walk-Off on the 23rd of August 1966.
You'll have in your hand, Vincent said, uh-uh.
The Wave Hill Walk-Off was a protest against the pay gap and poor working conditions, but it soon evolved into a far-reaching campaign for Aboriginal land rights. Vincent Lingiari and 200 stockmen, house servants, and their families walked off Wave Hill Cattle Station and set up camp at Victoria River. The Wave Hill Walk-Off lasted 7 long years. During this time, letters were sent back and forth between the government and lobby groups, and Vincent Lingiari gathered support for the cause in Sydney. On the 16th of August 1975, Prime Minister Whitlam transferred leasehold title to the Gurindji, famously handing soil to Vincent Lingiari. And on June 7, 1976, Vincent was named a member of the Order of Australia for his services to the Aboriginal people.
I want to promise you that this act of restitution, which we perform today, will not stand alone. Your fight was not for yourselves alone, and we are determined that Aboriginal Australians everywhere will be helped by it. And I want to give back to you formally, in Aboriginal and in Australian law, ownership of this land of your fathers.
Once more to sit down.
Vincent Lingiari was a central influence on the events leading to passing the Aboriginal Land Right Act in 1976. He is still celebrated to this day as a prominent leader and Indigenous activist.
A stranger appeared in the land, and he came with lawyers, and he came with great ceremony, and through Vincent's fingers poured a handful of sand. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow.